Anton Pavlovich Chekhov, A Daughter of Albion, translated by Constance Garnett. A fine carriage with rubber tires, a fat coachman and velvet under seats, rolled up to the house of a landowner called Grabov. Fyodor Andreevich Otsov, the district marshal of nobility, jumped out of the carriage. A drowsy footman met him in the hall. "Are the family at home?" asked the marshal. "No, sir. The mistress and the children are gone out paying visits, while the master and mademoiselle are catching fish. Fishing all the morning, sir." Otsov stood a little, thought a little, and then went to the river to look for Grabov. Going down to the river, he found him a mile and a half from the house. Looking down from the steep bank and catching sight of Grabov, Otsov gushed with laughter. Grabov, a large stout man with a very big head, was sitting on the sand, angling, with his legs tucked under him like a Turk. His hat was on the back of his head, and his cravat had slipped on one side. Beside him stood a tall, thin Englishwoman, with prominent eyes like a crab's, and a big, bird-like nose, more like a hook than a nose. She was dressed in a white muslin gown through which her scraggy yellow shoulders were very distinctly apparent. On her gold belt hung a little gold watch. She too was angling. The stillness of the grave reigned about them both. Both were motionless, as the river upon which their floats were swimming. "A desperate passion, but deadly dull," laughed Otsov. "Good day, Ivan Kuzmich." "Oh, is that you?" asked Grabov, not taking his eyes off the water. "Have you come?" "As you see, and you're still taken up with your crazy nonsense. Not given it up yet." "The devil's in it. I begin in the morning and fish all day. The fishing is not up to much today. I've caught nothing, and this dummy hasn't either. We sit on and on, and not a devil of a fish. I could scream." "Well, chuck it up then. Let's go and have some vodka." "Wait a little. Maybe we shall catch something. Towards evening the fish bite better. I've been sitting here, my boys, ever since the morning. I can tell you how fearfully boring it is. It was the devil drew me to take to this fishing. I know that it is rotten idiocy for me to sit here. I sit here like some scoundrel, like a convict, and I stare at the water like a fool. I ought to go to the haymaking, but here I sit catching fish. Yesterday, His Holiness held a service at Haponyevo, but I didn't go. I spent the day here with this she-devil." "But have you taken leave of your senses?" asked Otsov, glancing in embarrassment at the Englishwoman. "Using such language before a lady, and she..." "Oh, confound her. It doesn't matter. She doesn't understand a syllable of Russian. Whether you praise her or blame her, it's all the same to her. Just look at her nose. Her nose alone is enough to make one faint. We sit here for whole days together and not a single word. She stands like a stuffed image and rolls the whites of her eyes at the water." The Englishwoman gave a yawn, put a new worm on, and dropped the hook into the water. "I wondered her not a little," Grabov went on. "This great stupid has been living in Russia for 10 years, and not a word of Russian. Any little aristocrat among us goes to them and learns to babble away in their lingo, while they... there is no making them out. Just look at her nose. Do look at her nose. Come, drop it. It's uncomfortable. Why attack a woman?" "She's not a woman, but a maiden lady. I bet she's dreaming of suitors. The ugly doll. And she smells of something decaying. I've got a loathing for her, my boy. I can't look at her with indifference. When she turns her ugly eyes on me, it sends a twinge all through me, although I had knocked my elbow on the parapet. She likes fishing, too. Watch her. She fishes as though it were holy rite. She looks upon everything with disdain. She stands there with wretch and is conscious that she's a human being, and that therefore she is the monarch of nature. And do you know what her name is? Wilka Charlesovna Fies. Phew! There is no getting it out." The Englishwoman, hearing her name, deliberately turned her nose in Grabov's direction and scanned him with a disdainful glance. She raised her eyes from Grabov to Otsov and steeped him in disdain, and all this in silence, with dignity and deliberation. "Did you see?" said Grabov, chuckling. "As though to say, take that, oh, you monster. It's only for the children's sake that I keep that trait on. If it weren't for the children, I wouldn't let her come within 10 miles of my estate. She's got a nose like a hawk's. And her figure. That doll makes me think of a long nail, so I could take her and knock her into the ground, you know?"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.